Hello, how are you doing today? My name is Otto and welcome back to the channel. This is a video on how to set up your new DJI Air 2S. So I'll be talking about on how to set up the drone, the controller, and then we're going to be taking a look at the buttons of the controller and at the DJI Fly app as well. It's kind of like a long topic, so let's jump into it. Inside the box, we have the DJI Air 2S. It comes with a gimbal protector and it comes with a battery already on top of it. This is a remote controller and here we have two sticks at the bottom. We also get extra sticks for the controller. It's not like they're going to break, but I guess they can get lost pretty easily. If you open the phone holder, you'll see a cable that will let you connect the controller to an iPhone. And here you have two cables for phones that use a micro USB connector and for USB-C connectors. This is the power adapter to charge the battery. There is a USB-C cable to charge the controller, and you should have a full set of propellers. If you buy the Fly More combo, you are getting two extra batteries, a charging hub that will let you place all three batteries, but it will charge them one by one. You get this case with four ND filters, a few extra propellers. Oh, and you're also getting this cool looking bag. All right, so the first thing you want to do is to remove all the stickers. Now, unfold the arms like this. First, the front arms, and then the rear ones. To install the propellers, let's remove these foam caps. We have two types of propellers. One of them have this orange marking over here, and the other one doesn't have it. On the drone, we have two motors with also orange markings, and this is where you're going to place two of the props with the orange marks. On the motors that don't have a marking, you're gonna place the props that don't have a marking either. And the way to install this is you are going to align this part with this over here. You're gonna place it on top and press down, and then you're gonna turn this clockwise. If you need to remove it, you're going to push this down and turn counterclockwise. Here on the right side of the drone, we can insert a micro SD card. To remove the gimbal cover, you have to place your finger here. And then what you're gonna do is just push and pull away. There are going to be more stickers in here, so just remove them as well. To place the cover back on, make sure that the camera is facing forward, and then you start from the front towards the back like this. Always, always remember to never turn on the drone with the gimbal cover on. To remove the battery, press on these buttons on the sides at the same time, and then pull the battery upwards. Charge the battery using the power adapter. The first time you charge the batteries, I recommend charging them one by one by using only the power adapter and not the charging hub just for the first time for each one. The batteries and the charging hub are the same as last year's Mavic Air 2. And last year, there was an issue when charging the batteries on the hub for the first time, where one of the batteries would not activate and therefore it would not power on. DJI knew about this and maybe they fixed that already, but you never know. So first time, just charge them one by one. The battery lights will blink when it's charging and they will turn off when it's fully charged. You can quickly check the battery power at any time by pressing the power button once. There are four lights and each represents around 25% of battery power. To insert the battery, just place it on top of the drone and push it until you hear a click. If you want to use one of the ND filters, you have to remove first the small frame that is already on the camera. Maybe the best way is to hold the camera like this and then hold onto the frame and twist it counterclockwise. Grab one of the filters and place it like this. Charge the controller by using the supplied USB-C cable. Connect one side to the adapter and the USB-C plug to the controller. You can also use just about any power brick that you have. Remove the control sticks from the bottom and screw them onto the controller. Now pull the phone holder, and before you place the phone, let's put the plug here on the left side. This one over here. This is the cable that we have to connect to the phone. If this is not the right connector that you need, all you have to do is just get the correct one for your phone. To avoid confusions, I recommend paying attention to this mark that is on top of the connector. So on the new cable, you find the same marking, and all you have to do is replace this connector with this one over here. Place a smartphone with the charging port to the right side and then connect the cable to the phone. On your smartphone, make sure to download the DJI Fly app. Open the app, and now let's turn on the controller. To do that, quick press and then press and hold the power button until it powers on. Now let's do the same for the Air 2S. The power button is the one that is on the battery. Quick press and then press and hold the button until it turns on, like this. When it's time to turn off the controller or the drone, all you have to do is the same process. So you quick press, then press and hold until it turns off, like this. The first time you connect the drone, there's going to be an activation screen, so you just have to agree and fill your information. There's probably going to be a firmware update after that, so make sure to install it. Let's take a look at the controller. We already know that this is the power button over here. And in the middle, we have this switch with three flight modes. If you move the switch to the right, it will be in sport mode. And the drone will fly faster and it will be more responsive to your movements. All the way to the left, we have cine mode. And this will make the drone fly slower, but it will help to get steadier shots when making a video. This button on the left is going to initiate the RTH or return to home. To activate it, you need to press and hold it until you hear and see the confirmation on the screen that the drone is coming back to the home point. If you quick press this same button, it will also stop an action that the drone is making. For example, a master shot, a quick shot, or even the return to home. On this corner on the right side, this button will switch from video mode to photo mode and vice versa. All the way on the opposite side, we have this function button that you can single tap or double tap. It is customizable on the menus and you can select what you want it to do. On the top of the controller, the button on the right side will take a picture or it will start recording a video depending on what mode you're on. And on the left side, we have this wheel that will control the tilt of the gimbal. Since we're talking about the controller, let's talk about the control sticks. The first thing to know is that if you don't move the sticks, the drone is just going to hover. That's something good to remember actually, because sometimes when we are about to get into trouble, like about to crash, we start to panic, and that leads us to moving the sticks all over the place to try to avoid that. But sometimes it's better to just let go of the sticks. If you push the left stick up, the drone is going to ascend. And if you pull it down, it is going to descend. If you push it to the left, it is going to rotate counterclockwise. And if you push it to the right, it is going to rotate clockwise. On the right stick, if you push it up, it will fly forward. And if you pull it back, it will fly backwards. Pushing it to the left is going to make it slide towards the left like this. And if you push it to the right, it's going to slide to the right like this. The app is going to show us what the camera is looking at, and there's a lot of information that is being shown to us at the same time. The app is also going to allow us to change most of the settings for the drone. So let's start on the left side. If you press over here, the drone is going to get ready to take off. All you have to do is just press on the circle to confirm. If you're flying, this same button is going to be their RTH or return to home, and it will land automatically. If you use the app to take off, the drone is going to start the motors and it will ascend to about 1.2 meters. The other way to take off is by using the controller, and to do so, you push both sticks to the bottom and to the inner corner like this. Using this command, it will start the motors, but it will not ascend. And after that, you have to push the left stick forward to gain altitude. To land manually, without the app, it works the same, but the other way around. So all you have to do is hold down the stick until it lands. And don't worry, it will not land at full speed. If you press on this icon, it will open the map. So you get this size, and if you tap it again, you're gonna get a bigger size. Tap again to go back, and if you want to minimize it, tap on this little corner over here. Over here, we have the information on the current height and the distance of the drone, as well as the speed. Here at the bottom right side, we're going to select the storage, the internal one or the external one. Down here, we're also going to select the resolution and the frames per second. And over here, we can select the exposure compensation. This icon over here is indicating that we are on auto settings, and if you want to change it to manual, we just press over here. Now it's not called manual anymore, now it's gonna be called pro mode. And here we can change all the settings like the shutter speed, the ISO, and the white balance. Something interesting here is that you can select manually the settings that you want, but you can also choose any of them individually to set them on automatic. So for example, I can have the white balance on manual, the shutter speed on manual, but I can have the ISO set to auto. Up here we can see the battery level. The 78 represents the percentage of the battery remaining, and this number over here is going to be the remaining flight time. Right now it is at zero because it's not flying, but when you're flying, that number is gonna be changing. Next to the battery power is the signal strength between the controller and the drone, and the icon next to it displays the current GPS signal strength. Here on the right side at the bottom, we have the playback button, and in the middle we have the shutter button to start recording or to take a picture. This button over here is for the shooting mode, and here you can select what kind of picture you want, if it's single, auto bracketing, burst mode, or time shot. You can also select to shoot video, and we have two options, which are normal and slow motion. And from this menu, we can select the master shots, quick shots, hyperlapse, and panorama shots. If you are on video mode, you're going to get this little 1x button. And this one is for the zoom. Right now it's at 1x. If I press it, it will go to 2x and to 4x. If I press and hold it, it's gonna open a slider so I can zoom in and zoom out. Below the zoom button, we can switch to autofocus or manual focus. On the main screen, we can also select a subject and it will start tracking it. And the way to do it is to just draw a box on top of the subject. From there, we can choose to do active track, spotlight, or point of interest. To cancel the active tracking, all you have to do is just press on the X. Active track is probably the most popular one of those modes and my favorite. Once activated, the drone is going to keep tracking and following you. On the main screen, you can also tap and hold, and it will activate a virtual joystick that lets you control the tilt and pan of the gimbal. Up here on the very corner, we have these three dots, and you're going to be able to go into the settings, and we have multiple choices here, but the main ones are safety, control, and camera. On obstacle avoidance action, we can bypass, brake, or turn this feature off. If you choose to bypass, the drone is gonna try to bypass the obstacle, and if you choose to brake, it's just gonna brake as soon as it sees an obstacle. Here you can select settings like the maximum altitude the maximum distance, and the auto return to home altitude. Here you can manually calibrate the compass and the IMU. And here on advanced safety settings, you're going to choose what the drone is going to do if the signal is lost. I always choose to have return to home just in case. On the control tab, we can select the gimbal mode from follow mode to FPV mode. With this setting, we can allow the gimbal to tilt upwards for about 20 degrees. With this setting, we can tell the control to either charge or not charge the phone when it's connected to the controller. And here at the bottom, we have the function button customization, so we can customize what it does with one tap and what it does with a double tap. And here on the camera tab, we can choose the video format, MP4, MOB, we can choose the color profile, normal, HLG, or D-Log. And then if you're on normal, we can choose the coding format to H.264 or H.265. That was a lot of information for sure. I hope that it was helpful. And now please help me out by giving me a rating. Please give me a like. And if you like this kind of content, don't hesitate to subscribe. My name is Otto. I hope you have an amazing day, and I'll probably see you in the next one. Bye.